In today's video, I'm gonna show you how to collect and upload Modbus data to a standard MQTT cloud and OPC UA protocol conversion by using the Device Supervisor, Data Acquisition and Alarm Configuration. Log in to the gateway. Go to Edge Computing page. First, make sure Python Engine is on, then select Device Supervisor in the app list and submit. After a while, you can see the status is running. Go to Device Supervisor, Measure Monitor, Monitoring List. You can add your PLCs on the control list. Configure the measuring points and group them. Then you can monitor the status of the controllers and measuring points in the real time. Let's add a controller first. Click Add to configure controller parameters. Run the Modbus live simulation software in the PC directly connected to the gateway to simulate Modbus controller. Select the communication protocol of Modbus controller. IP address is the IP of the PC. Port number and slave are consistent with the Modbus controller. Leave the default advanced settings. Hit Confirm. Controller is created. Next, we'll add measure points of the controller to the list. Hit Add button, name it, put the register address and etc., then confirm. The measuring point and controller indicators are green, which means that the communication between the gateway and the controller and the data collection are normal. You can view all the measure points and monitor the values. Added the temperature measure point. There are periodic, unchanged, and never for the upload mode. When you select periodic, you can divide the measure points into different groups and set different report interval for them. Added the pressure measure point, and you can see several operation modes in the data calculation, such as ratio conversion, offset and zoom, and bit truncation. Let's take offset and zoom for example. Set the magnification as 0.01 and the offset as 5. The original value 1000 is turning to the calculated number according to the formula. The calculation formula of ratio conversion is typed on the screen. Bit traction mode can intercept a segment of the bit data in the original data and regenerate the new value. Go to the alarm page, real-time alarms, to check the triggered alarm information. Alarm rules, to manage the alarm triggering strategy. Historical alarms, view all triggered and restored alarm information. Alarm label, to manage alarm labels for convenient reuse. Go to the alarm rules page and add an alarm rule. Configure the name of the alarm rule, alarm controller, alarm measuring point, temperature alarm level, and warning. Set the alarm condition to less than 50 to trigger the alarm. Configure the alarm content. And finally, select the alarm label. Confirm. Go back to measure monitor, monitoring list. At present, the value of the temperature measure points is 88, which is greater than 50. So there is no alarm information on the real-time alarms page. Modify the temperature measure point value to 35. After successfully modifying the value, go back to the real-time alarms page. You'll see the triggered alarm. Change the temperature measure point value to 55. After it takes effect, as your alarm has recovered, you can see the triggered information of the previous alarms has disappeared when you return to the page of real-time alarms. You can find detailed historical alarm information on the historical alarms page, or you can filter or look up the alarm information by the name and time period. Publish and subscribe messages to standard MQTT. The cloud platform connected to the gateway is a public MQTT cloud platform of EMQX. Enter the official website of the EMQX and find public MQTT 5 broker in the Learn section, and you can see the MQTT connection information. Go to the cloud page, enable the cloud service, and select standard MQTT in cloud types. The client ID defines a unique ID, and the rest of the parameters use the default items. After the configuration takes effect, you can see that the cloud platform has been successfully connected. Click Add in Message Management to create a new published message. The release name is Devices Release. Selecting MirrorPoint group of a trigger source type, grouping label section default, topic is devices releases. The QoS level is selected as 1, the enter function is main. The function code can use a sample code. The writing method of publishing and subscription functions can be described in the user manual of DeviceSupervisor. Then click OK to submit the configuration. Back to the official website of EMQX and find MQTT WebSocket Toolkit. In the lower section, click Visit MQTT WebSocket Toolkit to enter the web page. Click New Connection to create a new MQTT connection and configure parameters such as name, client ID, server address, and port number. Submit and wait for the connection to be built. After the connection is successful, the connected prompt will pop up. Create a new subscription, enter the topic of publishing function of the gateway, and select QoS level 1. And then you can see that the data has been successfully uploaded to the cloud. Next, subscribe to the data distributed by the cloud platform. Go to Python Edge Computing page. Open the running log of DeviceSupervisor and check the data issued by the cloud platform. Go back to the cloud service. Create a subscription message. Set the name and the topic QoS level 1. The entry function is main. Payload type JSON. Use the default code and submit. Then go back to the running log page. There are the created publishing messages and subscription messages completed and being executed. Go back to the MQTT tool page of EMQX. Filling the topic subscribed by the gateway for the publishing topic and the data to be sent for a payload. The QoS level 1 is consistent with the subscription message. After clicking send, the published information will be displayed in the message box. Go back to the running log page. You can see the data received by the subscription message. Protocol conversion. Enter the protocol page. Modbus slave for mapping the mirror points to Modbus data. IEC 104 server for mapping mirror points to IEC 104 data. OPC UA server for mapping mirror points to OPC UA data. I will take OPC UA server as an example. Firstly, enable OPC UA server and set the port number and maximum number of connections. Then add mirror points mapping. Click Add, select the mirror points to be mapped and click OK. After that, you can see the mapped address and other information in the mapping table. Run the OPC UA client software UA expert to read the mapped data. Select Add in server of UA expert to add an OPC UA server and configure the URL of the OPC UA server. Select the OPC UA server just added and connect it. After a successful connection, open the data under Objects in Object and drag it to Data Access View, and you can see the data address, value, and other items. The data is consistent with the values collected by the device supervisor. Notice that the value mapped by the protocol conversion is the raw data, and the value being calculated cannot be mapped.
For more information, please visit inhandgo.com.